he's had the hatred in him. He blames everybody, his mother and everything else, society. But yes, we feel that he did. We're in the process now. We turned the information over to our Computer Crimes Task Force, which is an interagency task force headed over with the FBI. And they're in the process of looking at that blog to see if we can come up with anybody who may have saw these readings, and if they did, why did they not contact somebody?
Because law enforcement officials. So
pardon me?
As a law enforcement official,
yes.
Somebody's done some profiling and understood that. What do you think was happening with this guy over the course of the year?
I have no idea. That would have to be a mental health expert would have to say that. He just had a lot of hatred in him, and he was hell bent on committing this act, and there was nobody going to stop him.
Superintendent, why
yes.
do you think, in your opinion, to turn down the funds, be seen or not to be seen?
You know what, I think it might have been not to be seen, and there's the one wall is all mirrored, and maybe he thought that he could do this without looking, I don't know, without looking in the mirror. It's hard to say what's in somebody's mind when they commit those acts, but for him to go in there and just throw the bag down and pull the guns and have that many guns on him when he goes into place, but they were registered, three of the guns have been traced to him so far. The other gun was recovered at the medical examiner's office, and that's in the process of being traced as we speak. Two 9 millimeters, a 45 caliber revolver, and a 32 caliber semi-automatic.
Yeah,
that was in his pocket. The one was in his pocket. The other one, the one 9 millimeter, he used, dropped it at the scene. The other 9 millimeter, he used to spray some of the people, and then the 45 caliber, he put. He committed suicide with a 45 caliber.
Since the original briefing, there was some question as to whether or not an employee may have inadvertently turned off the lights, but you're certain now that he was the one who shut off the lights?
Yes.
Was there any indication of a fight with him earlier at a pizza place in that strip mall just before he went back into the club?
I have nothing of that.
We have no.
Nor does Collier Township. But we'll certainly check the tapes to make sure there was nothing on there. No, I'm saying the first 911 call was dispatched at 8:16. We're in the process of pulling the tapes now to review what time they came in.
How many do you think there are at this point as you go through it?
You mean 911 calls?
Yeah, how many different, I mean, there's like 40 women in the room.
Yes.
Some of them have cell phones, there are people here. But I mean, how many of these 911 calls came in, and were they all from cell phones? Was it some of the workers?
Some of the workers. We know that for a fact because we doing our interviews last night. You have to understand, and I'm sure you know, when the women who was in the aerobics class, what they do is they come into the class, they throw their keys in a corner along with their cell phones, so they didn't really have them. And I would assume most of them, the first thing they wanted to do was get out of there, and they ran out of the doors.
How long was he in LA?
No, he went in three times, Renee. He went in at first at 11 something in the morning. And then we're assuming he had to leave. They don't have to check out, but they check in. And then he went back in approximately 7:40. Then he checks back in at 7:56. So we're thinking in between 7:40 and 7:56, he makes his call on his cell phone. We know it was made at 7:45. So we're assuming he went outside to make that call, and he went back in at 7:56. The police are dispatched at 8:16. So we think he went in. He walked around, went into it. The class started at 8 o'clock. He went in and put his bag down and pulled the weapons and started firing.
Who did he call?
Yeah, tell us about that 7:45 phone call.
Pardon me?
Who did he call? The phone call he made at 7:45.
We're still in the process of contacting that person.
Superintendent, when did you first become aware of the blog website postings?
We became aware of it last night. After the incident. I don't think culpability, but I think that if anybody knew of it, they would certainly have a moral and ethical obligation, let alone a legal obligation, to bring it forward.
Did he have any conversation with the police when he was in there at 7:56 and 8:16?
We have no employee telling us that they talked to him, Renee. They didn't even. There's so many employees. I mean, there's so many guests. I think they have 3,800 registered people who come in and use the facility. What they do when they come in, they swipe a card and they just go about their business. And the employees, they said unless they have a relationship with them, they really don't know. And they'd say, well, it looks like someone I knew, but they didn't know a name. That was one of the hard things last night we had to do. And the homicide detectives and the police officers took great painstakingly pains to identify everybody. That's what was the holdup on getting everybody properly identified.
Sir, are you witnessing abuse in your cameras?
Pardon me?
Are you witnessing abuse in your cameras? Anybody say that they knew anything about this man's attitude, racial attitude?
No. There was no racial. There was no race in it. Pardon me? No, I'm talking about at the incident last night. There was no racial incident involved in it. No.
And you didn't target any one individual among the women in the club?
No, we do not believe that. We do not believe any woman that was shot or anybody that we interviewed said they had any type of relationship with this man.
What was recovered in his car? Was his car recovered and was there any additional weapons or?
No weapons.
But his car was recovered?
Yes, we took his car just to process it. We're going to process it downstairs. We haven't even got to that yet. Can I answer her first? What'd you say, Lane?
And what else? And his home? Anything recovered from his home?
Yes, we did go to the home. We recovered his computers, of course, which were still our computer crimes task force is analyzing. We recovered a note that said basically some of the things that I was going over before. And we recovered some long guns, but we did not recover any handguns from the home.
That was from how many?
Four.
Four long guns?
Yes, rifles, shotguns, that's right.
Now, can you talk a little bit, you said you know that he did some practice rifles.
Yes. That's what his writings indicate.
So you don't know if he had gone to watch this aerobics class?
We have no.
Or anything
we like know that? That he targeted this aerobics class by the mere fact that he had the schedule and had the aerobics class circled. In his home.
You mentioned the FBI is in the loop on this. Is there any indication this guy was on the radar or counterterrorism terrorism at all beforehand?
Absolutely none whatsoever. And they came just to offer any assistance that they could give us, but we didn't feel that we needed anything except using the Computer Crimes Task Force to analyze the computer.
Is there anything that a ball was dropped here because?
No. No, there's no ball being dropped. As I said before, the only way that this would have been prevented was if he had not been able to get the guns.
Yes. Is there anything that you think that anyone was actually reading this, or that he was just sort of writing into a void and being ignored the way he indicated he felt he was?
That's what our Computer Crimes Task Force is doing now, Bob. We don't have that information. They just got it this morning, and they're in the process of analyzing it and trying to track down if they can track down anybody who read it or if he paid anybody to be on a blog and things of that nature.
Is there any handwritten diary that's been discovered?
There was a handwritten note that I was going over before with some of the things he said, and then there was a the note at the scene was partially, there was a couple handwritten notes on it, but it was mostly typed.
Did he mention his family in that note as well, in this note that you find on him, which is kind of like a suicide note?
It's really not a suicide note at the one signed on him. He don't say he's going to kill himself on that one. It's the one at the hospice that says that.
And does that one mention his
no.
family as well?
Yeah, he mentions his mother.
Who said that?
Do you have a record?
No, he does not. I don't think they could have, no.
Does it appear that in general that no one could have prevented him from doing this? I mean, did he just kind of fly under the radar?
I think the only one that could have prevented it if somebody knew and read the blog, or if there's a person that, I'm not sure of how that blog works, if you have to pay to go on to that, if somebody was monitoring that blog, but we have no indication that they were. Maybe if they could have called the police, there may have been some intervention. But there was nobody that could have physically stopped that last night.
Did he live alone?
Pardon me?
Did he live alone?
As far as I know, yes. It was a little chaotic when the first officers arrived. And then when we get there, the scene, of course, is in the back of the huge facility. It's a very big facility. It's a 1.5 story, I guess you would call it. But it's up on the second story, there's a lot of treadmills and individual machines. The first floor has a basketball court, has a swimming pool, and has a huge room in the front where they can, individual works out with free weights or treadmills. There's a lot of treadmills. Then in the corner, as you go back into the corner, left-hand side, as you're facing the facility, was this room where the incident occurred, the aerobics room. I'm sure it's used for other things, but that's where the aerobics was being held. It's a room maybe time and a half of this room, maybe 20 by 20, 30 by 30 foot room. And everything took place right in that room. As you go enter the door, you go to the left, there's a light switch. You have to hold it for 15 seconds to make it go off. He said he was told how to work the light switch. Somebody in the club had told him, oh, you can shut it off with that. Nothing criminal in their nature. They were just telling him. He held it, knocked off the light, pulled out the guns. A woman or two said this was odd, a guy coming into the aerobics class. But they didn't think nothing of this nature. They just thought it was odd for him coming in there. Pardon me? You know what? It's every indication we have. He stood in one place and then he just started shooting. There's a lot of shots in the mirrors and things of that nature.
Was there surveillance video, sir?
No. Pardon me?
Any indication that he said anything?
No.
He never said a word throughout this whole
time? We don't have any indication of that.
So he emptied the clip of
one? No, I didn't say he emptied it. The first gun he did empty. I'm sorry. He drops that gun and then he pulls the other guns and continues shooting. Then he shoots himself.
On the same spot, presumably.
Yes. That's correct. And then where he's, the one gun still had 12 rounds in it in the clip. We don't know as we stand here what made him stop shooting. Thank God he did. But unless all the people who were still living had by that time run out of the room. It had to take under a minute. You start pulling that trigger, they go off pretty quick.
Can you go over again the guns? Which one you used first, which one you used second?
Well, there's 2 9mm.
Okay.
And then he used the other 9mm. Yeah, I don't know what. No, he did not empty both of them. He emptied one of them. The other one we recovered still had 12 shots in it. And then he took a 45 caliber and used it one time. And the 38 was never taken out of his pocket. 32. Automatic, semi-automatic, in his pocket. Yes.
One shot from the 45.
That's what we believe. Yeah, the medical examiner have to clarify that, but we believe it was from the 45. Yes.
Did you know when he purchased his weapons?
Position. He purchased two of them. The three that we traced, he purchased two in late 08, and he purchased one at the earlier part of this year, in 09. Legally purchased, and he legally had the weapons. Pardon me?
The 30-round clips were once illegal, but since 2004 have been.
Yeah,
talks about the appropriateness of those being illegal, and the individual is being able to do something like this.
The Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms was with us last night. They responded to the scene, too, to give us any assistance they could, and we went over that with them. And it's our understanding from them, prior to 2004, these extended clips were illegal. When they let the assault weapons ban expire, that took these out of the illegal status also.
Did you have carry permit, sir? How do you feel about that?
I'd rather not get into that debate.
Did he have a carry permit, sir?
Pardon me? Yes, he did. Yes, he did. He had a permit to carry.
Did you find ammo in the
No, we found some ammo in his bag at the scene. He had additional ammo with him in clips.
So how much potential firepower did he actually carry in there?
Well, we know he had 4 weapons fully loaded. The clips were 30 rounds. He had it, at least there was at least four clips. He had 100 or more rounds at his disposal at the scene. No, there's one way in, one way out. No, there's a room in the back, but no, they weren't. The door that you enter into opens up into the big fitness room, and that's where you go in and out, and that's what he did.
You know, and
no, yeah, well, it's from about that door over here to here. You come in that door over there, you turn to the left, and the light switch is there. He hit the light switch, the lights went off, he walked maybe 10 more feet, pulled out the guns, drops his bag, and starts shooting.
So the women who got out running past him? Or something?
Not really a pass him to the side of him, I'd say. Yeah, he wasn't blocking the door.
So maybe they got out because it was dark, and we couldn't see them?
No, I think they got out because of the firing, Renee, and then also with some of them were wounded by that time. He just said there's a lot of women there. He just said his hatred for women. Yes. Yes. No, I didn't say that. There's a lot of rambling on it, but there's an indication that the death date was going to be yesterday. I think he started thinking that, I think in his mind, there may be some indication that he had an altercation prior. He thought somebody was going to start looking at him, you know, but that's not true.
He notes a lot of
Right. We talked to the pastor. He
Sorry?
The pastor that you're speaking of, that's on his blog. We spoke to that pastor this morning. He knows all of them. He had quit going to that church. It's a non-denominational church. He had quit going to that church sometime in 06. So there's been no interaction with him. The only thing he had out there, he had a little, and it wasn't harassment or stalking to a female. She thought he was paying too much attention to her. But nothing of a criminal nature. So the pastor talked to him and it stopped. And that's about all the indication they had of anything, any problems with him whatsoever.
Okay.
Nobody had problems with him.
Of
who? We'd rather keep that for us right now, the family. Pardon me? I
the source of the photo.
I can't give you that. We just got a photo sufficient to say. Pardon me? No, it's not. No, it is not.
How was he dressed?
He had a black... He had a black headband on. He had a black duffel bag, and his clothing was black. Yes. He had a socks and shoes. He had a like a workout jacket, I guess you would refer to it as. Pardon me? Yes. Yes. Pants.
What did he do during his first visit?
Pardon me? There's no indication. There's no way of knowing. You just sign in and then you do what you want to do, and I mean you swipe your card and you just go about your business. That's all there is. We can go back and track him only so far. We have to get with his their headquarters, and they can give us a readout of how often he went. But we have indications that he was there a couple. He was there last month, and then there was a break and he may have been away, and then he started going again. But we have him there, off and on. Prior to 06, years ago.
So you don't know when?
Not exactly, no, I do not. There wasn't, no, you know, that thing with the woman, it was, the pastor really downplayed it. He said it really wasn't harassment or stalking. I apologize, I can't remember the exact word. He said overreaching or something. Something of that nature is the word he used.
Does his mother or brother live in this area? Did they ever report being threatened by him?
Not as far as I know. We have no reports of him that's come to our attention. We're letting the people, the family go until, give them some time and then we'll get to the family. We have no knowledge of any mental health issues. I couldn't go into a juvenile record if he had one. Chief from Collier has all that property. They can contact the Collier Police Department or the LA Fitness, right, Chief?
Yeah, some of the things we have, keys, valuables, we took at the time. Some of the other things are at LA Fitness, and they have them.
So if you're missing something, can you sell them, whatever, call your police,
and we'll let you know if we have it. If not, call LA Fitness.
We released a lot of it to the people last night. We let them come back in after we were done processing the scene. They got their keys, and a lot of them had their cars parked out there. Of course, there's going to be some that just fled the scene and did not come back yet.
When he stopped shooting at people,
yes.
He shot himself. Were there still women in that room, or did he shoot himself after everyone who had not been shot and fled?
Well, we have witnesses who see him shoot himself. So. Again, I think mental health people would better answer that than I. I can never make sense. I can't ever make sense of murders, you know.
You said that one hall there was
one. Yes.
There was also
a small door in the back. It was used as a like a fire escape or something like that.
But the room was
otherwise. Yes. Yes.
Where was
up against the wall. Put himself up against the wall between some stacked up, look like step stools that they use maybe for step aerobics, and he was right there up against the wall to the left of the door as you go in. And his body was, it appears that he was standing up, and then went right down onto the ground after the shot was
fired. If it's believed that he did act alone and this was
a very
disturbed man, what's the message then for people who live in the area, work in the area? Their nerves are obviously still pretty rattled right now.
Well, the message that we'd like to send, or maybe the chief can speak to that also, is that this is not an incident where we have a shooter, an active shooter out in the community. It's confined to that facility. We feel very, very certain that the man who committed the horrendous act is now deceased himself.
Well, and
Chief?
Is there any more questions? The superintendent told me that he will obviously update all of you when he gets more information on the case as the information comes in, as the investigation, the autopsies, and all the other departments do their job. We'll release that information to you. So if there's no... Sure.
Yes.
Which
the one at the home was handwritten. The one that he had on his in the bag was typed, and there was a note or two written at the bottom. Pardon me? Basically, yes.
Which side of the head did you shoot the top?
I believe you went from left to right. I believe so. Yeah. I'd have to get that. We don't move the body until the medical examiner gets her. We don't like to disturb it, and so we don't really do that until the medical examiner removes the decedent from the location, and then we get down and look at the autopsy.
Remember you called 745.
Yeah. We have it. No, I didn't say that. We'll release that information after we continue the investigation with talking to those people.
Is there any indication that that call that he had a conversation, or did he just call
somebody? We believe he had a conversation. We're not getting into that conversation. We're not getting into the contents of that phone call.
Yeah.
There you go.
And Kevin Avanto has the press release with all that information we talked about earlier. And again, you'll be briefed in with more information when we have it. And I'm sorry. And we also have a list of all the victims, their correct spelling of their names, their what age.
Yes. And what their condition was.
And what their conditions are as of the time of this press conference. So the superintendent will hand that out. You have one for everybody here?
Yes.
Yeah, we have a list for everybody, too, we'll hand out.
Okay.
Thank you.